So here's an idea. Let's get rid of this line, and instead, let's declare that nary is a decorator, and we'll write a definition of what it means to be a decorator in terms of updating wrappers. Then we'll be done. We've done it once and for all. We can apply it to nary, and we can apply it to any other decorator that we define. This is starting to get a little bit confusing, because here we're trying to define decorator, and decorator is a decorator. Have we gone too far into recursion? Is that going to bottom out? Let's draw some pictures and try to make sense of it. So we've defined nary, and we've declared that as being a decorator, and that's the same as saying nary equals decorator of nary. And then we've used nary as a decorator. We've defined sequence to be an nary function, and that's the same as saying sequence equals nary of sequence. Now, we wanted to make sure that there's an update so that the documentation and the name of sequence gets copied over. We want to take it from this function, pass it over to this function, because that's the one we're going to keep. And while we're at it, we might as well do it for nary as well. We want to have the name of nary be nary and not something arbitrary that came out of decorator. So we've got two updates that we want to do for the function that we've decorated and for the decorator itself. Now let's see if we can write decorator so that it does those two updates. So let's define decorator. Takes an argument d, which is a function. Then we'll call the function we're going to return underscore d, and that takes a function as input. And so it returns the update wrapper from applying the decorator to the function and copying over onto that decorated function the contents of the original function's documentation and name. And then we also want to update the wrapper for the decorator itself. So from d, the decorated function, we want to copy that over into underscore d and then return underscore d. Now, which update is which? Well, this one here is the update of underscore d with d, and this one is the update of the decorated function from the function. So here we're saying the new nary that we're defining gets the name from the old nary, the name in the documentation string, and here we're saying the new sequence, the new nary sequence, gets its name from the old sequence. And here's what it all looks like. If you didn't quite follow that the first time, don't worry about it. This is probably the most confusing thing in the entire class because we've got functions pointing to other functions pointing to other functions. So try to follow the pictures. If you can't follow the pictures, that's okay. Just type it into the interpreter. Put these definitions in, decorate some functions, decorate some nary functions, and take a look at them and see how it works.